much love. You know I hate to see you cry. In this morning's Saturday session, Barry Gibb, the last surviving member of one of the biggest acts in pop music history, the Bee Gees.
Last month, he released his first new solo album in over 30 years. You'll hear him perform in just a moment. But first, my conversation with Barry at Avatar Studios here in New York.
Did I read that you have a microphone in your bedroom?
I do have a microphone in my bedroom now, yeah, and speakers, and, right. And I turn all the lights off and have a little spotlight.
Uh-huh.
And, yeah, you do too, I know you do.
I love that image, though.
Yeah, I know. I know what you're doing at midnight, mate. It's just your
Barry Gibb has spent a lifetime in the spotlight. Most of it with his brothers, Robin and Morris, in the Bee Gees.
If you could be known for just one thing, would you rather be known as a member of the Bee Gees, as a songwriter?
As a songwriter.
Yeah.
I was writing songs when I was 8 years old.
Yeah.
And I never looked beyond that. Except the wonder that Morris and Robin would naturally do three-part harmony.
The Bee Gees would perform, write, or produce 15 number one hits. But when Morris died in 2003, Barry felt the Bee Gees were over.
Truthfully, I've never stopped writing songs.
You haven't?
I just didn't think anybody was going to listen to them anymore.
You know? Didn't?
No. But I'd lost that feeling of being amongst my brothers and making music where, if we all agreed, it was good. You don't
know. Barry and Robin talked about recording again, but this would be their last session together for CBS Sunday Morning in 2009. To love somebody. When Robin was secretly battling cancer.
He never told you?
He didn't tell me, no.
Are you sorry he didn't tell you? I mean, do you?
Yes, I'm sorry he didn't tell me. But at the same time, how would I have responded? You know, I would have turned into another doctor, another person who was concerned about him. Mm-hmm. And I don't think he wanted that from me. I'm going back
to Massachusetts. Robin died in 2012. So today is the last track on Barry's new album, the song End of the Rainbow, is dedicated to his brothers. In the end of the rainbow.
I visited Robin in the last 2 weeks before he passed, and he was in a coma. There I am sitting next to him and singing this song, you know, which I don't know he heard. I just don't know he heard.
Mm-hmm. But you needed to sing it?
I needed to sing it to him. And the doctor called me up one night and said, this is the time, this is the chance.
Yeah.
Nobody else is here right now. So I went in that evening, and I remember all the noises. And the beeps and the oxygen mask and all this, all the things that you don't really want to remember, but I'll never forget. Singing a home
to the sun. Barry wrote the album In the Now with two of his sons, Ashley and Stephen, who also toured with him 2 years ago.
It's still a family business for you.
Yeah, well, it's not even a business, you know. Mm-hmm. It's still a family that loves music and shares music. What I miss is my brothers.
Yeah.
But I'm not alone.
Barry paid tribute to his brothers on that last solo tour.
But now I have to sort of explode on my own.
How do you explode on your own?
In the bedroom.
Now, performing the title track from his new solo album, In the Now, here is Barry Gibb. You're only my destination, and all I think about is yesterday. I need you here in the now, in my heart, in my soul, in the now, in my heart, in my soul, in the now. So wrapped up in you, and I can. can only wish that you could feel the way I do. I found a love and I can't get enough to hear the sun standing right in front of me. So